in the last class, we have understood the concept of relative motion in that we wrote the formula for relative velocity and relative acceleration. We also understood how the direction of VAB is opposite to the direction of VBA. So in the last class, we learned the relative motion. So that completes your second chapter. So in this class, let us try to solve few problems based on the motion in a straight line chapter. So here is the first question. So first question is, a farmer has to go 500 meter due north, 400 meters due east and 200 meter due south to reach his field. So the path of the farmer is given and he is going to his field. So if he takes 20 minutes to reach the field, so the time taken for a farmer to reach field is 20 minutes. So in that, the first question is, what distance he has to walk to reach the field? So here distance is asked. Next is, what is the displacement from his house to the field? So in second, he is asking the displacement. Third, what is the average speed of farmer during the walk? So here it is average speed, here it is displacement, here it is distance. And the fourth is, what is the average velocity of farmer during the walk? So in this question, you have to find what is distance of farmer, displacement, average speed and average velocity. Before that, let us draw the diagram for the distance covered by the farmer. So this direction is north, this direction is south, this is east, this is west. North, south, east, west. In the question, a farmer has to go 500 meters due north. So he is moving 500 meters due to north. So this direction is for north and the distance is 500 meters. And now, so 400 meter due to east. So this line should be smaller compared to this line because here it is 400 due to east. Next is, and 200 meter due to south. So half of this line, so because he is traveling 200 meters due to south. So from point A, the farmer has reached to point B, that is 500 meter distance, and from point B has reached to point C, that is 400 meter distance, here 500 meter, here 400 meter, and from C to D, it is 200 meter distance. So the first question is, what is the distance he has to walk to reach the field? So to reach field, so he has to cover AB plus BC plus CD distance. So the first is distance, which is equals to AB plus BC plus CD. So that is 500 meters plus 400 meters plus 200 meters. That is 1100 meter. Totally he has walked 1100 meters to reach the field. Next is displacement. So displacement from the diagram, it is clear. So the displacement of the farmer is A to D. So displacement is the shortest distance between two points. So this line is the shortest distance between the point A to point D. So AD gives you the displacement. So this can be written as AB minus CD whole square plus BC square. Now if you substitute, AB is 500 minus CD is 200 whole square plus BC is 400 square. 500 minus 200 is 300 square plus. So this can be written as 3 into 10 power 2 whole square plus 4 into 10 power 2 whole square. So 3 3 is 9, 10 power 2 2 is 4 plus 4 4 is 16, 2 2 is 4. So if you take the common term, 10 power 4, then you get 9 plus 16 into 10 power 4, which can be written as root of 25 into 10 power 4. So answer for this, root 25 is 5. So root of 10 power 4 is 10 power 2. That is 500 meters. You can also find the displacement directly from the diagram. So this is the distance that you have to find, AD. AD is not known to you. So but from the diagram, if you draw the perpendicular line to D, so then this line cuts this line and makes it two parts. So you know this distance is 200 meters. So then this distance can be 200 meters. So from this, and so in 500 meters, you got 200 meters, and what left here is 300 meters. So now you have this base of the triangle. So this vertical distance you need to know. So this distance is equals to this distance. So 400 meter here is equals to 400 meter here. So this is the right angle triangle. So by applying the Pythagoras theorem, so if I apply the Pythagoras theorem, so the second, so or you can also solve the second problem in different method. So if I name this point as O, AD square is equals to OD square plus OA square. So AD will be equals to what? OD square plus OA square. AD is, OD is how much? 400 square plus 300 square. So that will give you 500 meters. So from this method also you can solve for displacement. So the third point is to find the average speed. Average speed is equals to what? Total distance by total time. So distance we found, it is 1100 meters. So it is 1100. Total time is given in the question. It is 20 minutes. So this is in meter. This is in meter, and this is in minutes. So if you cancel, then you will get 55 meters per minute. That is 55 meter per minute is the average speed. Next is fourth. Fourth is to find the average velocity. So average velocity is the total displacement by time. So displacement is AD. AD we found it as 500 meters divided by time is 20 minutes. 00 gets cancelled, what remains is 25 minutes per minute. So this is average velocity. So for the above question, so for this question you found what is the distance and what is the displacement, what is average speed and what is average velocity. For displacement measure, I have discussed two types. So first, whenever there is a question given based on direction, try to find or try to put this diagram. So if they have said 500 meters, so if you have taken length for 500 meters as this, then whatever the distance you take for next, take with respect to this. So here he has said 400 meters. So 400 meters length should be less than 500 meters. And here it is 200 meters. The length of this should be less than 400 meters. Or it should be half of this 400 meters. So using this diagram, we found what is distance, what is displacement, what is average speed, and what is average velocity. So the second question here is, a particle is moving with the velocity v is equals to 3 plus 6t plus 9t square. So velocity of the particle is given. It is v is equals to 3 plus 6t plus 9t square centimeters per second. Now find out the acceleration of the particle at time t is equals to 3 seconds and b is find the displacement of the particle in the interval t is equals to 5 seconds to 8 seconds. So he has given the velocity. So velocity is 3 plus 6t plus 90 square centimeters per second. So now he is asking what is acceleration. Acceleration A is rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So if you differentiate this, so differentiate 3 plus 6t plus 9t square. So differentiation of the 3 with respect to t is 0 because there is no variable t here. So first differentiation is 0 plus differentiation of 6t with respect to dt is 6 because differentiation of t by dt will give you 1. Next is, so differentiation of 90 square, so 9 is as it is, t square, differentiation of t square is 2t. This can be written as 6 plus 9 to 18t. This is the acceleration which is in centimeters per second square. Next is, he is asking to find acceleration of the particle at time t is equals to 3 seconds. So he has given time. So substitute this time in this. A is equals to 6 plus 18t. A is equals to 6 plus 18 multiplied by 3. A is equals to 60 centimeters per second square. So you found the acceleration of the particle at time t is equals to 3 seconds. Next is displacement of the particle in the interval t is equals to 5 seconds to t is equals to 8 seconds. So you have to find the displacement of the particle. So for displacement, v is equals to 3 plus 60 plus 90 square centimeters per second. So ds by dt is velocity. So 3 plus 60 plus 90 square. So velocity can be written as rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So this is equals to velocity. Now to get the displacement, you have to integrate this. Ds is equals to 3 plus 60 plus 90 square multiplied by dt. Now to eliminate d, we have to apply the integration. So integration of dx, ds is equals to integration of 3 plus 60 plus 90 square dt. So integration of ds will give s. So now the limit for time is given. It is from 5 seconds to 8 seconds you have to integrate. So this can give 3, integration of 3 with respect to t will give 3t plus integration of 6t with respect to dt will give 6 into t square by 2. So here power of t will get added to 1 and in denominator you have to write power plus 1. So for t square, how do you write? T square can be written as 3 t square plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1. This is how you have to do the integration. S is equals to 3t plus 3t square plus 3t cube. Substitute the value. So for first term, 3t you substitute two limits, plus 3t square you substitute two limits, plus 3t cube you substitute two limits. So how do you do this? S is equals to 3 multiplied by 8 minus 3 multiplied by 5 plus 3 multiplied by 8 square minus 3 multiplied by 5 square plus 3 multiplied by 8 cube minus 3 multiplied by 5 cube. So if you do this, then you will get S is equals to 128. So 1287 centimeters is the solution for this second problem. Next question here is, the motion of a particle along a straight line is described by function x is equals to 2t minus 3 whole square. So there is a object or there is a particle, and the motion of this particle along the straight line is described by the function x is equals to 2t minus 3 whole square. Now where x is in meter and t is in seconds. So if x is in meters, then we say that x is either distance or displacement. T is in seconds, so T is time. Now from this, find the position, velocity and acceleration at time t is equals to 2 seconds and find the velocity of the particle at origin. So what is given here? X is equals to 2t minus 3 whole square. So to get the position at time t is equals to 2 seconds, just substitute 2 here. 2 multiplied by 2 minus 3 whole square. So 2 is 4 minus 3 whole square. 1 meter. So the position at time t is equals to 2 seconds is 1 meter. Now he is asking to find the velocity. Velocity is what? Change in displacement with respect to time, v is equals to dx by dt. So x is given to us, it is 2t minus 3 whole square. So if the square is given for the term, then you have to differentiate it like this. So if you differentiate this whole term, then you will get what? 2 multiplied this with the same term. Okay, then you have to differentiate this term. So here there is no t with 3, so you can ignore this. There is a t with 2t. So if you differentiate 2t, what you will get? You get 2. So that is equals to 4 2t minus 3. If you substitute t in this, t is what? 2 seconds. 2 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. 1 multiplied by 4 is 4 meters per second. Next is acceleration. Acceleration is dv by dt. So you got dv by dt as 4 multiplied by 2t minus 3. You can write this as 8t minus 12. So there is no variable here. You can ignore this. So differentiation of 8t is 8. So 8 meters per second square. Next is find the velocity of particle at origin. So at origin t will be equals to 0, so x will also be equals to 0. If you substitute x is equals to 0 here, so 0 is equals to 2t minus 3 whole square. So 0 is equals to 2t minus 3. So this is for x. Now so for velocity, we got velocity is equals to 4 2t minus 3. So if you substitute value of 2t minus 3 in this, you will get 4 multiplied by 0. So velocity is 0 meters per second. So you have to substitute value of this in this equation. Then only you will get the velocity at the origin. So this is the third question. So third question was the motion of a particle along the straight line, which is described by function x is equals to 2t minus 3 whole square. So where x is in meter and t is in second. So now he is asking what is the position, velocity and acceleration at time t is equals to 2 seconds and find velocity of the particle at origin. So to do this, you need to know the differentiation very well. So if you differentiate displacement, you will get velocity. If you differentiate velocity, you will get acceleration. If you integrate acceleration, you will get velocity. If you integrate velocity, you will get displacement. So you need to be thorough with integration and differentiation, and how the integration are and the differentiation are interlinked to this three physical quantities, displacement, velocity and acceleration. So you need to know how these three are interlinked by the mathematical formula, differentiation and integration. Then you can easily solve any question based on acceleration of the particle or velocity of the particle or displacement of the particle when the function is given to you. So the function means, so the displacement is given in this type are known as the functions.